Hello and welcome everybody to another installment of Iffy Car Reviews. In today's episode, we'll be looking at one of the most popular and successful import from Japan in 1000cc category. This is the Toyota Passo. Toyota Passo starts its life as Daihatsu Boon, but later on it was rebadged and sold as Toyota Passo and Toyota Sirion. It was first launched in 2004 and is currently on its third major facelift. The first gen was from 2004 till 2009, the second gen was from 2009 till 2015, and the third gen is from 2016 onwards. Let's take a closer look now. First of all, thanks to Umar Motors in G94 for providing me this wonderful opportunity to review this Toyota Passo. From the start, the Passo was designed keeping interior space in mind. As we can see, the interior space in this car is very good for a subcompact hatchback of its size. The cabin is very roomy. With the big rear window and door windows, it allows plenty of sunlight into the car, and that is why it is very bright and it feels very open. The Passo was designed with European tastes in mind. That is why it has larger and stockier frame. It has numerous safety features and it delivers impressive fuel economy. The car originally comes with a 1.0-liter or 1.3-liter engine, and it was offered with front-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. Some of you might also remember that the Daihatsu Boon came as the X4 variant, which had a 1.0-liter turbo engine and four-wheel drive. From 2016 onwards, it is only available with 1.0-liter petrol engine. The example we have here in our review today is a 2015 model. Usually the Passo is offered in few different trim levels, which are commonly known as G, which is available with 1 or 1.3 liter engine, plus HANA, available with both 1 liter and 1.3 liter engine, and HANA Apricot Collection. There is another trim level that is X variant. There are a lot of options with minor to major differences in trim levels, but for the sake of this review, we will keep things simple, just concentrate on the main trims liked by the people here. The HANA usually means that we get climate control and better headlamps and inclusion of fog lamps. What I have noted at this trim level is that most of the cars are not offered with keyless entry, with this little soft black button on the front door handles. I think making this little feature an optional extra is an oversight by Toyota. It also comes with different colored side door mirrors, which I believe is a matter of taste, but I personally don't like it very much. What I think happened was that Toyota just ran out of meaningful idea at that point of time, and they just did the first thing that came to their minds, which did not cost them money, and just ran with it. Corporate thinking at work. But let's get on with the review and find out why this car works for the masses and why is this car loved by the masses.
Under the hood is a naturally aspirated 1-liter inline 3-cylinder dual overhead cam VVT-i engine that kicks out nearly 69 horses at 6000 rpm and 91 Nm of torque at 4800 rpm. It has 4 valves per cylinder and multi-point fuel injection system with 10.5 to 1 ratio compression ratio. CO2 emissions are as low as 99 grams per kilometer, that makes this little engine Euro 5 compliant. With a CVT gearbox mated to this little engine, it has top speed of 187 km per hour and it reaches no 200 in 15.2 seconds. The example we have in our review today is a 2015 model. It is the second generation Passo and it comes up with all the basic features such as power windows, power side mirrors, power steering, central locking with immobilizer and keyless entry. The Passo has very attractive lines. Like discussed before, depending on the trim level, you get halogen or projection headlamps with or without fog lamps. The headlights are level adjustable as well. Also on the lower trim models, you get normal rear light clusters, which are done in red color. The higher trim cars have tail lights that has clear transparent effect. Well, in my personal opinion, I would prefer the red colored lights. They go very well with the lines of the car and in most colors suit the car better. Also, if you are lucky, like in case of this example today, you will get a reversing camera pre-installed from Japan. The side view mirrors I have already discussed before, so we will leave it at that. The interior of the Passo is a very nice place to be. It is very spacious, airy and bright. You do get cars with either standard two separate seats or the more popular ones, something called as sofa seat in the front. This bench seat in the front is better from a practicality point of view. You can get more people in the car as the gear shifter is on the steering wheel that gives open leg room in the front, which makes it very comfortable on long journeys. The dashboard and instrument cluster are very minimalistic but looks very nice. The material used are up to usual Toyota standards. These doors have all hard plastics and the switches are simple but of very good quality. The steering wheel has tilt adjustment but it does not have any telescopic adjustment. The front seats have both forward and back as well as height adjustments. So the drivers of different heights should be able to find a comfy driving position. The car comes up with reversing camera and it has these integrated guidelines which makes reverse parking really easy. Instead of a conventional handbrake, Passo comes up with this foot brake. To set, push this pedal, and to release, push it again. It has very simple speedo cluster with easy to read dial. It has this little screen that displays odograph, trip meter A, trip meter B, average fuel economy, idling time, this is the time engine is stopped by the system, gross time idling is since the reset, temperature. You can switch off or on the eco function with press of this mode button. And a clock above and fuel gauge on the left. The car does come up with this Japanese infotainment system installed that has TV, CD, DVD player and navigation system unit as well, but that is usually not in working order and options are limited due to Japanese language only. I have noticed most people get rid of it and get an aftermarket one. That is some Chinese head unit, but that does provide more usable options for us, although the build quality is not as good as this Japanese one has. The front speakers are in the dashboard corners near A pillars. It has space in the rear doors for speakers, but no speakers are installed on most models, so you have to get your own. Down below are three simple rotary knobs for climate controls. It has zone selector on the left, fan speed in the middle, and temperature controls on the right. With air conditioning, rear window defroster, and hazard button above, and recycling control down below. This car also comes up with traction control. Here is a 12-volt power outlet. Shopping hanger up to weighing up to 3 kg. A convenient storage pocket. And two cup holders for the front passengers. Instead of a conventional glove box, it has this open tray for storage, so no privacy. It has this convenient pocket and storage in the center armrest. At this stage, I have to point out a few blatant omissions by Toyota that bear mentioning. Please bear with me and hear me out. One of my friend was proud owner of Chinese Cherry QQ. He pointed out a few things to me that have since bugged me quite a bit. Let's consider the power windows operation buttons. Why is the driver side window operation button the only one that is eliminated? The Cherry QQ had all the buttons on all the doors illuminated. Not only that, all the buttons were controlled by the interior lighting brightness controls too. And all the buttons were fully automatic. Standard stuff, you would agree. I think Toyota should include these small features in the Passo or even the Vids or Corolla for that matter. Another thing that I as well as my friends have noticed is that the seats of the Passo are not very comfortable as I think they should be like. They are not bad, but I am saying this because the seats are quite straight and lacks the lower lumbar support. Looking at the rear seats, there is quite a lot of room here, more than what would you expect from its compact dimensions. Just like the front, everything here is nice and solid. A point to note here is that these 40-60 split rear seats don't slide forward or backward, but they do have recline adjustment in two levels.
As you can see, these rear seats have been designed to accommodate three people in comfort. There are three seat belts and three separate headrests for three people. I can picture three people of my size easily fitting in here. There is plenty of legroom and sufficient amount of headroom. These big windows do provide good visibility and you do have a commanding view of the road ahead. So overall, I would have to say it is a very functional environment. Now let us start up the engine. You need to put your foot on the brake and turn this keyless ignition key. Now let us take her for a spin around the block and see how does it drive like. As I mentioned earlier, the Passo is offered with either 1 liter or a 1.3 liter engine, but the most common ones imported here in our country are with 1 liter engine because of the high tax regulations. So we will focus on that. The engine is a 1 liter 1KR FV inline 3 which produces around 70 horsepower at 6000 rpm. The steering of the Passo is lively. It has been tuned for city driving, so it is really easy to park this car and maneuver through busy marketplaces. It is a little fun car to drive. Also, a point to note here is that the cabin insulation is very good. The car is quiet on motorways even. The cars imported here in our country usually comes up with a continuously variable transmission, although simple automatic or manual transmission are also option. But they are few and far between, difficult to find and more expensive. The Passo comes up with either front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive configuration. The most common argument among buyers in our country is to go for the front-wheel drive as it will consume less fuel, is simpler and lighter. But I think you may give the all-wheel drive consideration as well. It's no bad thing. So we recently helped a friend to get a Passo, and he opted to go for the all-wheel drive version. His reasoning was that it is an added bonus to have in some sticky situations, as he lives in rural areas and he has to deal with lots of unpaved and muddy roads that becomes a hazard, especially in the rain. The guy says that he has noticed that his all-wheel drive Passo has got him out of some situations where the front-wheel drive cars were just plain stuck. Be it Civic, Corolla, Vitz or Passo or any other front-wheel drive car. And for those of you who likes to go to hill stations, it provides better traction in hill climbs and in snow as well. So the all-wheel drive version has its merits and it can be a potential choice for you. As the old saying goes, when you need it and you don't have it, you sing a different tune. The one thing that is a common complaint with the Passo is the sluggish acceleration with this continuously variable transmission. I have noticed that for myself as well. This is especially more prevalent in the all-wheel drive version. It is not so bad that the car becomes undrivable. It is just something that you would need to get used to. From all the research that I have done, the sluggish CVT is a common problem with all Passo models. Other than that, it is a very pleasant car to drive. The car is quiet and smooth on the road. It absorbs the bumps very well. However, it is slightly low for some rural roads and you will experience scraping the underbody of the car on some tall speed bumps. Even compared to Suzuki Swift, the Passo is much smoother and provides a very relaxed ride. The fuel economy is also very good, and provided you keep the spark plugs maintained and the injectors clean with good cleaner every 6 months or maybe annually, you will see up to 15 kilometers within the city and up to 20 kilometers on the motorway. People will make a big fuss over the all-wheel drive version consuming more fuel and so on, but the difference is minuscule and the benefits of having the all-wheel drive outweighs the negatives.
Overall, Passo is a little fun car to drive. Even the lack of power I mentioned earlier does not diminish the joy of driving it. It has good fuel consumption, good safety and equipment level, and it comes up with Toyota's legendary reliability. Looking at the boot space, it is practical with 225 liters of cargo space. If required, you can always fold down the 40-60 split rear seats to increase the cargo capacity to 630 liters, which enables you to carry bulkier objects. Due to these reasons, it has found its niche as a very capable small family subcompact car, scoring 4 out of 5 stars in the Euro NCAP tests. Passo has independent McPherson strut and coil spring suspension up front and torsion beam in the rear. It has front ventilated discs and rear drum brake configuration setup that comes up standard with ABS. Overall body length is 143.7 inches, width is 65.6 inches, height is 60.4 inches with a wheelbase of 96.1 inches. Total curb weight for this car is 910 kg.
So, the Passo is a good little car for all intents and purposes. It is the Mehran of Toyota Japan. But that is okay because the car comes with features that are not even present in the most expensive local made sedans, and it has very spacious and comfortable interior. So that makes it a good choice for either a family car or a second daily driver for the family or kids. It is quite well priced as well. Prices for a good Passo starts from 1.1 to 1.5 million rupees from 2011 to 2015 model. The newer ones like the one we have in our review today is a 2015 models are closer to 15 lakhs, but in that range or a bit more, you may get a Vitz as well, but it's your personal choice. It is a good choice for a car if you are looking for something in this segment. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like this video, please leave a comment and stay tuned for upcoming reviews of new cars.